Someone lives here to build that building.
Somebody maybe live there. But I know, you know, always with us human beings, when you see something like this, you say, ah, what is happening here?
Maybe you see the matter. Indeed, the matter. Keep matter.
Who built this building here?
Money again about here.
Who planted this beautiful garden here?
Money in the plan is around.
Who made this wonderful, beautiful swimming pool?
He was down. As the running, you want to be back
in our mind. Always we believe that nothing will just come out like a boom. It must be an origin. Somebody behind something. You know, for this light to shine, there is a power. And that power is somewhere, even if you don't see it. And it came through the wire. And now we have the lights here. But if I can put this light off, I don't know where they are. Okay. Now if you can put it off, the lights are off. But if she can switch on, now the lights are off. You can see, there's some, anything to happen, there's something behind it.
And
such a person, if you give him this example, the one who refused or who rejected the existence of God. You know, either they will run away from you, or they say, ah, you are out of your mind, bother. But the truth is that anything that happens behind it, there's something. So man does not come by itself.
So, Barasmanada,
man has an origin.
So, Menesha Allo, Balabita.
And the origin is God.
Balabitu.
That is why the book of Genesis, chapter 2.
Let's see, I think verse 7.
Let us see this. And God breathed into the nostrils of Adam, isn't it? The Lord God formed the man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostril the breath of life, and the man became a living being.
Amen.
So the man became a living being because of the breath of God that God breathed on man. And this is another proof that man has an origin from God. It doesn't just come by itself like the boom. Or maybe gradually from another small insect to a monkey and now to a human being. And I will ask them, what about those monkeys in the bush today? What has happened with them? Can they not change also to a human being?
So what in the minute? Because also another basgaminate manada. We mean this job? Almatan.
So for me, those scientists who say there's no God, they are 100% foolish. And the Bible tells us who say there's no God is fool.